Hello everyone, welcome to Skills Build Training YouTube channel. My name is Kamran and this channel is all about showing you how to become an IT pro really fast. In this video, we are going to talk about what are APIs and how do they work. So without any further ado, let's get started. If you are a programmer, then you might have heard of API. The full form of API is Application Programming Interface. Simply, we can say that the API is a middleman that delivers your request to the provider from which you are requesting something and then delivers the response back to you. The API hides the complexity and we do not need to worry about that what is happening at the backend. We just request for something and get the result. Whatever the processing is done at the backend, we are not concerned about it. This is the one of the primary benefit of using API that it hides the complexity. Additionally, we can extend the functionality of our existing system by using the API. For example, you have developed an application in which you are providing information of the surrounding, like you are providing the maps and traffic information. If you want to extend the functionality and want to integrate the weather information, then you can do so by using the weather API. Let's imagine a scenario to understand the working of an API. Imagine that you want to buy a car. For this purpose, you will go to any car center. You will give your order to the car center and the car center will give the order to the manufacturing company. The car manufacturing company have multiple processes that they do in order to make a car. For example, they have the manufacturing plant, paint plant, assembly unit, and they do many things in order to make a car. But you are not concerned with the processes that are happening in the background. You just went to the car center. You gave the order to the car center and car center forwarded your order to the manufacturing company. The car center works like an API in this scenario because it receives the order from you and forwards your order to the manufacturing company. It receives the car from the manufacturing company and gives it to you. Now let's see another scenario. Imagine a waiter in a restaurant. You are the customer and sitting at the table with a menu of choices to order from. And the kitchen is the provider who will fulfill your order. You need a link to communicate your order to the kitchen and then to deliver your food back to your table. In this case, the waiter is a link between you and kitchen. The waiter takes your order, delivers it to the kitchen, telling the kitchen what to do, and then it delivers the response, in this case, the food back to you. So in this scenario, the waiter works like an API. Similarly, we use the APIs to perform login on different online platforms from Facebook and Google account. If you are using any social media service, then it gives you the option to login from your Facebook and Google account. When you perform login from your Facebook or Google account, there is an API which works in the background and gets the essential information from your account to perform the login. There are many APIs that the developers use to achieve a functionality. For example, the Google Maps API, Weather API, and etc. So now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna give you a demo of an API that how you can use the API to get the data. The API that I have selected is Open Weather Map API. It gives us the information of the weather. So in this case, if you have to get the information, you cannot deploy the sensors all around the world to get the information of the weather. However, you can use the API to get the weather of any location, right? The Open Weather Map API is a very simple API. It is also available for free and it gives us the information of the weather. In order to use this API, first of all, you have to open up your browser and then you have to visit this page, home.openweathermap.org. If you have not created your account before or you have not signed up, then you have to perform the sign up and then you have to log in. After that, you will see a dashboard like this. And here you have to click on your name and then you can see that you have got an option My API Keys. So when you will click on My API Keys, you will see a screen like this. So every API has an associated key, or you can generate your own key as well. In order to generate your own key, you have to enter the name of the API key. So for example, My API Key, and then you have to hit enter and it will create the API key for you. And you can see that it has created the My API Key. In every application, we have to provide the API key in order to access the functionalities of the API, and every application is distinguished by the API key. For example, your application will be distinguished by any other developer's application through the API key. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to copy this default API and I am going to implement a simple Python program in which I will use this API of Open Weather Map, and I will get the information of the weather. The Open Weather Map API is also available as a library in Python. So I am using Linux Mint to demonstrate you the working of the Open Weather Map API, and this is my terminal. In order to install the Open Weather Map API as a library, you simply have to write on your terminal pip, and if you are using Python 3, then you have to write here pip 3 install py open weather map. So when you will hit enter, it will be installed in your system and you will be able to use this API in your Python script. As I have already installed it, so I will close this terminal. I have the Spider IDE, so I'm gonna open it here. And now I will explain to you that how this API works and how we can get the weather information. So first of all, you have to import your API here, or your library here. From pywm, you have to import Open Weather Map API. All right. Next, we have to provide the key of our Open Weather Map API. So I have created a variable here to store my key, and this is the syntax to store the key. So I have simply copied my key from the website and I have pasted it here. Next, I have created a variable which is the manager variable, and it has the information of the weather manager. Next, we have created a variable for observation, and here the manager.weather at place, and you have to provide the name of the city and then the country. So I want to see the weather of the Halifax, which is a city of Nova Scotia, Canada. For this purpose, I have written here Halifax, and this is the name of the country, that is Canada for sure. So all the information of the Halifax weather is now stored into this observation variable. And then I have another variable which is equal to w, and w is equal to observation.weather. So now all the information of the weather is stored into the w variable. The API returns the output in the form of the JSON. So when I print this variable, I will get the result in the form of the JSON, right? JSON is the JavaScript object notation. So now we can further call multiple functions and we can get the detailed information of the weather. So if I print it here, that w.detailedStatus, it will show me the cloud information, like the cloud are scattered or they are not scattered. So it will present the cloud related information. In order to see the wind information, I have to call this function, that is wind. So w.wind, it will show the information of the wind. And the humidity information can be retrieved from this humidity. So w.humidity, it will show the humidity information. If you want to get the temperature, then you have to use this function, which is temperature function. As I want to get the information in the Celsius, and if you want to get the information of the temperature in Kelvin or Fahrenheit, then you can define the Kelvin or Fahrenheit here instead of Celsius. And if you want to get the rain information, then you can write here w.rain and it will show the rain information. And similarly, we are getting the heat and the cloud information as well. So the idea is that this is a very simple code. I am just using the API and I am getting the information. I am not accessing any type of sensors in my script. There is a weather API which will work at the backend, and when I will run this program, it will return the information or output to me. So let's run our Python script. All right, so you can see that we have got our result on the console. And first of all, it has printed the whole information in the form of JSON because we have printed this W variable, right? And then we have the cloud information, and it says that the overcast clouds, and this is the wind information. The speed is 0.51 and it is on the 160 degree. It is the humidity information, that is 84. The temperature in Celsius is 11.31 and the maximum temperature will be 13.01 and the minimum temperature will be 9.71. But the temperature feels like 10.69. Alright, there is no rain information and the heat index is none and the clouds is 85. Alright, so we have got the information of weather of Halifax. So whatever the information we have got here, it is very simple for us to understand, and we do not have performed any complex processing. Every processing is done at the background. It has hide the complexity of the processing and we have access our results. And similarly, you can change the name of the city here and the name of the country, for example, London, and the country would be Great Britain. So when you will execute your program, you will get the information of the London weather. That's it for this video. If I conclude this video, then in this video, we have learned that what are APIs and how do they work. We have seen a couple of real-time scenarios to understand the working of the API. And then we have discussed the Open Weather Map API and we have seen its working. If you really enjoyed this video, then give it a thumbs up. If you have not subscribed to our channel, then please do so by clicking on the subscribe button and hit the bell icon. If you have any feedback to share, then let us know about your feedback in the comment section. Thank you so much and see you in the next video.